This is a role play developed as part of the course curriculum for Manage TB, an online course for doctors. The participants have enacted the roles given to them. The case discussed does not refer to any existing patient, but has been developed as part of the course curriculum. The investigations, such as x-rays and lab reports, used in this case scenario belongs to patients treated at National Institute for Research in Tuberculosis, Chennai. Their identity have been anonymized.
Good morning, ma'am.
Yeah, good morning, Pratiksha.
Ma'am, I have a case to discuss with you. Can I discuss it now, ma'am?
Yes, you can discuss it now.
Ma'am, there is a 3-year-old male child. He is admitted in the ICU with eye fever, irritability and not taking feeds. There is one episode of convulsions.
Can you elaborate more on the clinical and treatment history of this child?
Sure, ma'am. The child had a history of fever for 3 weeks, which was eye grade and continuous. History of irritability for the last 2 weeks. The child was treated in a nearby private hospital by intravenous antibiotics for the last 2 weeks, but he showed no signs of improvement. The child had one episode of generalized tonic-clonic convulsions yesterday night. Previously, there was no history of seizures, no developmental delays, and the child was immunized appropriately for age. The child's grandmother was treated for sputum-positive pulmonary TB for 6 months and completed treatment for 6 months ago. She is the one who usually takes care of the child. There's no history of any treatment for primary complex in this child. The child is non-reactive for HIV. The test was done in a private hospital. I've done a thorough systemic and general examination of the child. The child is febrile, conscious, alert, but the child is irritable. The child has neck rigidity, no focal neurological deficits, no sensory or motor deficits. And there is the MRI shows basal meningeal enhancement and mild dilatation of lateral and third ventricles. Ma'am, if I have to rule out TB meningitis in this child, what are the investigations I need to do further?
Yeah, you have to look out for the raised any signs of raised intracranial tension. So you have to do a fundus examination, look for papilledema. If there are no contraindications, then you can proceed with the lumbar puncture. CSF analysis, you have to send it for cytology, AFP smear and culture, biochemical analysis, and one sample has to be sent to gene experts. And also we have to rule out the bacterial and viral causes of TB meningitis. So the sample has to be sent for viral and bacterial organs reasons also. And you have to, in addition, do a chest x-ray and a Mantoux test for this child. I hope you know about the CSF findings in a case of TB meningitis.
Yes, ma'am. Usually the CSF will show lymphocytic pleocytosis in TB and the proteins will be elevated. Plus there will be decrease of glucose. The decrease of glucose can be either a decrease of glucose in the CSF or a decreased CSF to plasma glucose ratio. Ma'am, if the expert is negative and there is no other bacterial confirmation for TB meningitis, can I rule out TB in this child?
No, gene expert is only an adjuvant test in the diagnosis of TB meningitis. Anyhow, a negative gene expert does not rule out the diagnosis of TB meningitis. So, the diagnosis should be based on clinical, radiological and the CSF analysis in totally together.
Okay, ma'am.
So can you just summarize the key findings in the diagnosis of TB meningitis?
Yes, ma'am. So the key messages will be the lumbar puncture for CSF analysis has to be done for diagnosis of TB meningitis. CT brain with contrast is indicated in comatose or deteriorating patients. Negative microbiological confirmation does not rule out TB meningitis. The decision to treat for TB must be based on clinical features and CSF findings.